Hey, traders, this is Christian Kramer, Tribe Banking 30 with your end of day recap for what's today? Today's Tuesday, right? So we have another update again for the S&P. We logged in another green day up about 20 basis points, depending on if you look at S&P futures or SPY. I think SPY finished up 23 basis points. Q's finished up just about flat, and actually small caps, which I didn't see up just until now, finished down a little bit on the day. But again, some really good sector outperformance. If you are a trader in this market where you can move kind of quickly, this has been a great market for you. The option activity has been just phenomenal the last week and a half. And it's really just been a great market to trade too. So, so why do I say that? If you look at some outperformers on the day, the industrials, this group, if you've just been paying attention to flow and where the money's been going, the industrial group, and again, I'm not even looking at any of the individual names, I'm just looking at the whole group, which tells you how powerful the rally has been. But up again, 52-week high. We talked about last week how there was a big rotation into industrials. Apparently, they may not be done with that. If it was about $1.8 billion went into this XLF. And money came right out of the consumer staples XLP ETF. So that has continued this week. Names like, you can just go through some of these charts, but Boeing has been absolutely on a tear. 3M looks pretty strong. Oops, it's double M. I'm on 3M. 3M is trying to break out here. I think UTX also broke out this week. And even if you go to the rail names, I mean, UNP looks like that XLI chart, just really, really strong, this UNP. This UNP has just been going since December. It was 118. It's now 141, a rail name. Just absolutely unbelievable. So these are the names that are in that industrial ETF and backing up. And it looks like there's still names that look pretty attractive. We were looking at the Honeywell chart today. That one's trying to break out too. But we've seen this just all over the place. What I've kind of noticed is a lot of these types of charts where, you know, names have liked up, there's been consolidation, and then there's another name or another move higher. We've seen that just over and over. Dow DuPont was a good example of that. Dow actually did not finish on the high, so it could be that it's coming to an end. Or at least pausing right here, but this was a hell of a breakout over here. We started to see this in the defense group as well. This is Lockheed Martin, consolidation, breakout. RTN was my stock of the week to kind of watch for a breakout. No major option activity, but that one's been moving nicely this week. And then, really the two other sectors for the day were biotech. It was kind of a tale of two biotechs this week. Yesterday was horrible, in terms of the price action. It just fell all the way. But at least it fell into the top of support, which I think we talked about yesterday, that at least it fell into some support. And so I was making a joke earlier that yesterday was the pit of misery. Today was dilly-dilly for a lot of these names. I mean, some of these names, it just looks like a massive grab. To get into some of these names, this is NKTR, which was one of the first aggressive option trades of the day. This thing, again, you have to look, just to look at how crazy this is, up 18%. Gilead, I thought, was the trade of the day, because they just kept on coming after Gilead today. Big block, a couple aggressive orders. And this is a couple times now where we've seen, Gilead, I actually looked at this trade earlier in the week, and I did not pull the trigger on it, but we've seen aggressive call buying a couple times, and it just kind of was like, this thing has just been hanging around this white line, this 200-day moving average, and I've been in and out of this a couple times, and I kind of just said, all right, let me wait a little bit to get back in this name, and the thing just took off like a rocket today, from $74 to $78, and I was even thinking midday, I'm like, all right, well, let's see if we can get over this line that I've got drawn. So, it's now into this little gap, and I think it looks great. I mean, another name, that has not done much of anything other than, it kind of had this nice move after earnings a couple quarters ago, but then has been a little bit of a uh, has been a little bit of a problem area since then. So, again, looking for names, looking for groups that may not have participated yet in this rally. There's a couple other ones that acted really well in the biotech space today. GBT, I'm still holding on to a little piece of this one. Real nice maneuver, and this is another one up 19%. I feel like there's one more in this group that did this, but I can't remember. Another one to watch, I'd say, is AGIO. We saw a real aggressive call buyer towards the end of last week in this one, and this one also made a nice move, 5%. So, also, what I'm in is XLV. I talked about this a couple times now, so I'm kind of beating a dead horse, but the implied volatility in this ETF is an 11. Versus, if you want to play XBI, which is fine, it's not all that expensive, it's about a 23 if you go out to March options or February options. So that XLV making a nice move, and it's cheap. So, always take a look at the implied volatility of the options and realize what kind of a move that the options need to really work. A good example of that is XNET, XNET. Oh, I remember which biotech name it was now. But, this name I just bought stock today because the implied volatility is super, super jacked. It's like a 75 RSI, not RSI, implied volatility. But this was a nice name. I bought at 2070 up to 23.5 one day. So that's the kind of moves that we're seeing right now in this market. It's pretty nutty. ARRY was the other name that saw aggressive call activity. I did jump into this name. I think the implied volatility is 150 in this name. So we're talking about a $13, $14 stock. I just bought stock. Again, you always have that option. If it just doesn't make sense with the option pricing, if it's too big of a move, you have the option of buying stock when it's I think anytime it's below a $20 stock, certainly it's in the wheelhouse. But they went after this one like crazy. ARRY. And it's not the first time that we've seen this in this name. But they bought a nice block of these. 3,200 of the Feb 14 calls, they really went after the Feb 14 calls, which is a little bit out of the money. And even before that, today, if I can find the trade, they did a risk reversal where they bought calls and sold puts. They bought the 50, I think this matched up. Yeah, here we go. They bought the June 15 calls and sold the June 10 puts. So if you just looked at this trade and forget about the February trade, they're going out. They're certainly giving themselves some time in that. And again, you can see implied volatility is a little bit. Maybe I screwed that up between XNET and ARRY. The implied volatility is 77 with this particular order. And I think it was higher with XNET, but I think you know what I mean in terms of names that have a really high implied volatility. They're expensive. That goes into the pricing. Just to go through a couple of other names, financials were the third theme of the day, I would say. I think industrials, biotech, healthcare, and then financials. So XLF did try to break out for the day. It did not finish on the highs, just like it did here. I was a little bit concerned because I did get long financials looking for this breakout after this consolidation, and it did not close on the highs here, but it kind of held in and has been drifting higher. So, if it continues to do this, I can overlook the not finishing exactly on the close of the day. It did take out one of these purple lines, VPOC. We have another one up here. We also saw a little bit of KDE. Yesterday it was KRE that we saw some call spreads in. Today we saw KBE. Right at the end of the day, a nice sweep, about 2,000 shares of the February 50 calls. That should cover. Earnings. If these banks are going to do well, I would think that trade does well. Again, that's a lot to be said. The banks obviously have to do pretty well. But so those were the three trends of the day. You can see even there was more UNP calls, just unbelievable. A couple other trades, just more in the biotech space. There's a little bit of Abbott short-dated calls that went up. I mentioned the Citigroup. There were some Wendy's calls. There was NTR calls, another name. I tell you, if you look at some of these charts, to me, when I see something like this, I mean, look at this thing. $1 to $52, I think either blockchain or I think a pot stock. I think this one is a pot stock, but you know, those are the names that, I mean, $5, you know, forget about even a dollar, but $5 to 52, come on. Some of these moves are just outrageous and unbelievable, you know, and again, I said in the beginning of the video, I'll say it at the end, if you have an open mind for some of this stuff and just don't get anchored into saying, oh, this is ridiculous, these shouldn't be moving this much. You know, as long as you're disciplined and you're taking targets, you get out of the trade, maybe leave a last piece on, you know, there's nothing wrong with participating in these names, even though they're pretty crazy. I will say that there was a decent amount of puts going up in some names, so maybe a little bit of protection going up, some chunky puts going up as well, and some names that we've previously seen call buying in. And then also the VIX moved up. So we did do a trade. You know, again, the VIX moving up from a very low level, you know, from a 9. So I'm not crazy concerned that it's a 10. But, you know, just in a relative overall market view, we've had an amazing run at this point. So I did put out a trade idea earlier on how to kind of hedge yourself going into earnings. You know, earnings is a very choppy time of the year, a couple weeks where all those names report. But yeah, you can see the VIX kind of just ramped right into the close. So that's usually not the best signal for the next day. But we'll see how that shapes up for tomorrow. And yeah, so I'm not going to detail the whole trade that I did. I put together about a 5-minute video on a way that you could kind of sell some upside index calls to protect yourself until we, and if we do either get a little bit of a pullback or at least a choppy market while we get into earnings, which is just around the corner. All right, so that's it for today's video. And have a great night. Thanks.